the cricket match. Well done, boys. It is the first time our team has qualified for the finals. I hope you play to win the trophy. The ground at Sawan is ready for you, said Mr. Pradhan, the chairman of the factory, as he came over to congratulate the winners. Sawan is the township of the chemicals factory nearby. The Sawan's school cricket tournaments are an annual event sponsored by the factory. This first victory of the Raja's 11 was an event to celebrate. All of them piled into the township bus, and there was a lot of singing and dancing all the way home. Ashok, the captain and the player of the Rajas, and his friends were seated in the last row. They were engrossed in a vigorous post-mortem of the match. The following evening at 3:30 sharp, the boys were ready to start practice. There was a cold breeze, but the warm winter sun made it a pleasant afternoon. One by one, each boy took his turn to bat. It was Sunil's turn to bat. He had just hit a couple of balls when he straightened up to wipe his brow. Gosh, it is hot. And I thought it was still winter, muttered Sunil. Stop fooling around, boys, ordered Ashok. If you two want to break, go ahead, let me bat, he added. Soon he too felt uncomfortable and could not connect bat and ball. His eyes began irritating him. No, today is not my day. I think I will call it a day, said Ashok under his breath. Look, Ashok, see that smoke from the factory chimney, cried Rahul. That is it. That is why we are all feeling uneasy, sputtered Raju between coughs. By now, Ashok's eyes were red and watering. Raju's cough was getting more frequent. Rahul and Sunil felt uncomfortably hot. Their teammates, too, were uneasy. The grey-black smoke cloud was slowly spreading across the blue sky. The beautiful winter noon was marred. On reaching home, Ashok washed his eyes and felt better, but very soon the irritation returned. At dinner time, Ashok's mother noticed his red eyes. Did you hurt yourself, Ashok? Asked his mother. No, Ma, but there is some irritation, added Ashok. Maybe we should see a doctor tomorrow. The next morning, Ashok and his mother went to the polyclinic. While they were there waiting to see the optometrist, Raju arrived with a bad cough and fever. He too was accompanied by his mother. This time Raju's cough is more severe. I hope the doctor is able to give a medicine to cure it permanently. He never had this problem in Ahmedabad, said his mother. She looked worried. Just then Ashok and his mother were called in. The routine tests proved that Ashok did not need glasses, but looking at his eyes, the doctor was not too happy. After conducting more tests, he said to Ashok's mother, Well, Mrs. Jain, I feel that Ashok's eyes have acute allergy. It is good you have come early. With proper treatment, he should be cured. I wish something could be done to keep the air cleaner. The number of such cases is on the increase, said an agitated Dr. Bose. Then he turned to Ashok, and Ashok, at least during the treatment, avoid going out much. Ashok felt that the whole world had crashed around him. His head bent down, he walked out of the doctor's office. That evening, when the boys came to call Ashok for practice, he told them about his visit to the doctor. The boys were flustered. But Ashok, you are the team captain. Without you, how can we play? Wailed Rahul. Maybe I will be all right in a few days, then I will join you. But all of you carry on with the practice. The boys were upset, yet they decided to practice. They then went to Raju's house. There too they were greeted by an ailing Raju. He was also affected by pollution. The best player being laid up was too much to take. The boys went to the field, but no one had his mind on the game. While on the field, the smoke from the factory once again blew over the field, affecting the players. They all went back to Ashok's house and told him about the thick smoke blowing over the field. Most of the players were coughing. Ashok felt depressed. I feel really bad, especially when we have come this far and for the first time, moaned Ashok. But this smoke is making it impossible for us even to practice. Sunil was angry. We have to do something about the smoke or we cannot play the match. We have to do something about the smoke or we cannot play the match. Let us meet Mr. Pradhan in the morning. I will come with you, suggested Ashok. They all went to the factory to see Mr. Pradhan. Mr. Pradhan was standing on the veranda. On seeing Ashok and his teammates, Mr. Pradhan came forward to greet them.
"I hope the field is in good condition and you boys are practicing hard," he said.
"Though we would like to practice hard, we are not able to do it," said Ashok. "Sir, the smoke from the factory is affecting all of us," added Sunil. Mr. Pradhan went into the details of the past couple of days. He was deeply concerned. He said after a pause,
"We do have plans for putting in air filters and planting trees around the colony, but somehow they got postponed. I think now I will press the matter."
"But these are long-term measures, sir. What about the match on Saturday?" asked Sunil. "Sir, if I may suggest, could you shut down the factory a day before and on the day of the match?" asked Ashok hesitantly. After a few minutes of consideration, Mr. Pradhan agreed.
"After all, Sawan too has a stake," he said.
The players were thrilled. For their daily practice, they used an open field further away from the colony. The day of the finals arrived, a perfect cool winter day. As the factory was closed, the spectator stands were packed to capacity. The trophy on one side of the ground was glittering in the sun. The two teams came onto the field in their whitest of white uniforms. The Nawabs, oozing confidence. The Rajas, nervous but optimistic. Mr. Pradhan tossed the coin and the Nawabs went to bat. The match was exciting, fought evenly by both teams. The successful partnership between Raju and Ashok got the home team the trophy. As they ran back to the pavilion, they looked up. They could see an unpolluted, clear and beautiful blue sky.